Hey everybody, have I got anybody in class today? Holler if you're logging in to learn how to make a kid's favorite dish. They could live off this and you would never have to serve anything else. Maybe everybody already knows how to make macaroni and cheese. Hey Debbie. This is a good, fun recipe. I'm gonna start, hey Robin, and wash my hands. So all of you go wash your hands if you are making this with me, and then we'll get started. Hey Sivia, hey Paige and Robin. Okay, I am ready to get started. Macaroni and cheese is something that every single kid likes, and it's a good dish for them to get started with cooking because it's really very easy. One thing I know about macaroni and cheese is that everybody has a different way of doing it, and everybody thinks their way is the right way. But I'm gonna show you the right way. In my humble, however accurate opinion, this is the right way to do macaroni and cheese. Every good macaroni and cheese begins with a roux. And roux is spelled R-O-U-X. So with some X's all up in there, that's not American, is it? No, that's French for brown butter. If I were inventing the spelling, I would have spelled it R-O-O like a kangaroo, but that's not it, it's R-O-U-X. So I wanna show you how to make a roux to get started. We're strangely not putting any eggs in this dish. I know a lot of macaroni and cheese has eggs, but this one does not. This one's going to start with a roux. So we are gonna start with a stick of butter and a third of a cup of all-purpose flour. I'm gonna tilt this right here so that you can see. I've already boiled my macaroni because that's about a no-brainer. All you have to do is boil it and strain it. A roux is something that a lot of dishes begin with, which is just a butter sauce. If roux is French for brown butter, this isn't gonna exactly get browned, but if you've ever tried to thicken up something after you get all your sauce made, then you're gonna put a little flour in it. You probably noticed that your flour kind of lumped up and then you had to break down all your flour lumps. Well, it won't do that with the roux because you're basically mixing your fat with your flour. So it should melt. Turn my heat up a little bit. Butter's trying not to melt. It's trying to stick in to that flour, become like a cookie or something. We're not gonna let it. I'm on about a medium-high heat because I don't wanna turn it up too high and scorch my butter. You know, a lot of dishes that are pasta dishes begin with a roux, and then they add all their spices and their flavors and their seasoning to it. See how nice and smooth that is? That is much better to put the flour in there when you're only dealing with butter, because you put the liquid in there and that flour is going to lump up. Then you're gonna have to get out a whisk and do more work. So you can see that my butter is melted. And I'm gonna slowly start adding my 3 cups of milk. And as I add, I'm going to stir. And it will turn into a nice, smooth mixture. You don't see any lumps of your flour in there like we would have seen if we had put our milk in first. Okay, now I need a teaspoon of our house seasoning. You remember when we made the house seasoning before? Okay, that's what we're going to use. So I've got my teaspoon. That's gonna kick it up with some flavor. Oh, good grief. You're not supposed to spill it all over the stove. Put some more in for how much I spilt. I want to get this mixture really warm, and it's not really warm after I added all that cold milk in there. So I've got my heat on medium high. That just looks like really just looks like milk right now, doesn't it? Doesn't even look like it's going to turn thick, but it will. Now, I already have boiled my macaroni. I just put 16 ounces in a pot of boiling water, and you can see it's al dente, which means it's not big and rubbery. It's still very, it's still just a little bit. It's not a little bit hard, not at all. But it's not, I didn't leave it in the water long enough for it to just keep growing and become rubbery. So I've just got it in a straining colander right here, sitting right next to this roux I'm making. Okay, I know it's getting warm because I can smell that seasoning that I just put in there. It's smelling pretty good. I'm gonna want this to get a little thicker before I take it off the eye though. And I like to stir it on the bottom because I don't want that flour to settle down there and start getting scorched on the bottom of my pan. You see the butter trying to climb to the top and rest on the top of the milk? It usually takes a few minutes to get this to where it's thick enough to start adding your ingredients. I'll talk to you for a minute about my cheese. The recipe calls for 4 cups of cheese. You can use any kind of cheese. If you have cheddar, you can use that. If you have mozzarella, if you have Parmesan. So when I went to go get my cheese out, I was gonna do all cheddar because, you know, kids like all cheddar. But I just happened to have some mozzarella in there too. And I had some leftover Parmesan from where I had made zucchini the other night, and I thought now would be a good time to use up that Parmesan. If you use a lot of different cheeses, you're going to get a richer flavor. I use macaroni and cheese as an opportunity to use up whatever cheeses I have on hand. If I don't have any cheese, which is hardly ever, if I don't have any cheese, you know, I would buy whatever cheddar and just make it. But I really like, and so all I've done is, I still have 4 cups, but I put all my Parmesan in there and I put my cheddar in, and then I've put some mozzarella. So right now I have, I'm making a mess again. I have 3 different kinds of cheeses in my bowl, just because that's what I had in my refrigerator. And we're trying to use recipes that make good use of things we already have. Still a little thin. I'm going to let it thicken up a little more before I add in there. This is going to be sort of the sauce that the macaroni is swimming in once we get it in the pan. While I'm waiting for that, let me show you how I intend to prepare my pan. I told you that when I ran out of pan spray and they ran out of it at the store, I have been using this Easy Greasy because nothing ever sticks to it. You don't have to, and if you don't have a pastry brush, I'm doing it with a paper towel. So that you can see, you don't even need a pastry brush to do it. I'm just dipping a little out and putting it on the sides and on the bottom because pasta tends to get very sticky and we don't want it to stick to the bottom of our pan. So if you have not tried this product, I really like it. It's called Easy Greasy, and I think you can get it on Amazon and at easygreasybaking.com. Now, I saw the milk jump, which meant that it is at the boiling point. So that should be where we are with our sauce right now, our butter sauce. Scraping it on the bottom. Make sure nothing is sticking. When I get ready to add my cheese, I'm only going to add about 2 cups of my cheese. And you know I have 4 cups. So, and I'm going to remove this from the heat before I add my sour cream because the sour cream is cold and this is very hot and I don't want to curdle anything. So usually all I do is just slide it off the eye. This sauce is going to make your mac and cheese so creamy. I know a lot of grandmas like to put some eggs in there, but I always feel like there's scrambled eggs in my mac and cheese when I eat it like that. So we've been stirring it and it has come. We have brought it to the boiling point because I saw it jump. The more I stir it, the more I cool it down. Can you see the butter just laying on the top? Okay. I'm going to, you see the bubbles that are coming up? Can you see that? Those are some little bubbles that are coming from the bottom. That's when you know you've got it at the boiling point. You don't want to keep it boiling for a while because it will scald. So I'm just going to, now you can see it's thicker now, kind of like cream, once we brought it to the boiling point. So I'm going to move this off of my eye. And while it's still hot in there, gonna add about half of this cheese. That's gonna make it a good bit thicker. And it's very easily melting because we know that it was hot to start with. Now, keep in mind, I'm off the heat. And I'm just gonna put in my sour cream. Can you tell how much thicker our roux is now? I want to get it stirred around until it is smooth. I don't want lumps in my, and those lumps that you're seeing are sour cream, they're not flour. But I'm just gonna get it, kind of stir it until everything dissolves. Now I'm going to take my macaroni that I've boiled and I'm going to start putting it into this sauce because I want all of it to get stirred up. I want all of it to be coated. We've already prepared our dish with the Easy Greasy, so I'm confident it will not stick. But this is a good simple recipe. If you've got a young baker or a young cook in your house, this is a good one to start them out because there's not a lot of ways to mess it up. Now, do you see how creamy that's gonna be? We're gonna pour all of that. We've got a substantial roux here. We're gonna pour about half of that into our dish. I'm gonna move the dish over here in range of the camera. I'm gonna get something that will. I'm gonna put half of this in until the bottom of my pan is covered. Once I get it distributed, I'm going to take another cup of cheese. This is going to make it layered, so you get some cheese in every bite, because you know how when you go to the family reunion, some people, they just take all of their macaroni and cheese right off the top. And then when you get down to the bottom, there's nothing but juice left. Well, I'm gonna outsmart that. That is the wrong way to do somebody, is to eat all the cheese off their mac and cheese. Okay, so now I'm going to put the rest of it . You can probably already guess what I'm gonna do with the last bit of that cheese. Now this has no eggs, so if you've got anybody with an egg allergy, no problem. Macaroni and cheese is about the most perfect marriage in history. Look at that, isn't that pretty? Now, gonna stir up my last little bit of cheese and I'm going to distribute it across the top. I've already preheated my oven to 375. But you know what I could do? If I didn't want to cook this until dinner time, I could just put some foil over the top, sit it in the refrigerator, and just wait to bake it later. That's what makes it a good dish to take somewhere else. You can mix it up when you've got time and then bake it right before you're going somewhere. Now, the last thing that this recipe calls for is 4 tablespoons of Italian breadcrumbs. So here's my tablespoon. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the reason I like this part is because it kind of gives you a little bit of smack on the top. I'm mixing it here with 2 tablespoons of butter. Now, I thought my butter was just about to the melting point because it's been sitting over here by the stove, but it's not, so I'm just going to stick this in the microwave for 30 seconds. Hey, Mary Alice. Hey, Sharon. Hey, Lee. Hey, Linda and Jamie. Waiting on my microwave to beep. I can smell how yummy that is. But this will, because we've mixed it with the butter, it's going to crisp up. And I'm just putting a little bit of it, kind of sprinkling it as a topping. It's a little hot for me to be handling like that. Now, I personally have never found anybody who wouldn't eat this. You might have. Somebody's gonna send me a message saying I would never eat that. But I'm just saying, of all the people in the world that I know personally, everybody can be fed some of this. And you see, that was a very simple task, but very yummy as well. So now all that's left to do is put it in the oven on 375 for about, 35 or 45 minutes? Until about 30 minutes. So until all that cheese has had a chance to melt in with all of that seasoning that we put in there and get those little breadcrumbs crispy. And that's as easy as it gets when it comes to a family favorite thing to make. If you are a young baker and you want to help me with some of my live videos, send me a message at the cookie school, because I would like for some young bakers to come help me, because people would rather look at somebody cute than somebody old. So I would love to have you. I've got a few little friends that are going to great places right now, like Amelia Island and stuff. So I don't know why they want to go to Amelia Island and not come here and bake with me in my kitchen, but apparently it happens. So anyway, I'm just going to put this in the oven and it will be ready for my dinner. It refrigerates well. It saves, as if there's any leftover, it will save from day to day. So I hope that you will make the macaroni and cheese and post a picture up on the cookie school or send it to me. I am really very honored by all of the young bakers who send me messages and tell me how much they enjoy baking and cooking. I happen to already know a secret about that. You really want to be in the kitchen with your mom, and I think that is a wonderful place for you to be, because you will be totally prepared to take care of yourself one day and your whole family and everybody who lives in your college dorm if you already know how to boil some macaroni or boil an egg or some of those really easy peasy things. So thanks for sending me those messages. I really enjoy getting those. And if you would like to help one day on a live video, send it to me. I will see you Thursday, where we are going to make seriously great popsicles. Can't have summer without popsicles. Bye now.